Hey guys, Alex here, and today I'm here to bring you guys another video tutorial showing you guys how to blur a background on a photo in Photoshop CS6. So it's very simple. All you're going to need to do is have a photo. In this case, I'm just going to open up a photo. It's no big deal if I open up file, open, and just open up a photo on my desktop. It's just a blue flower. I got it today from, I just took it with my Canon camera, Canon 60D. And yeah, I'm going to be showing you how to blur this. This is just a very simple circle. I mean, you can go into more in-depth videos, but first of all, you're going to need to have is, as you see, the background is already pretty much blurred. What you're going to need to do is you're going to need to have the pen tool. So just select the pen tool from your list of tools. Let me just find it, because let's see if I can even find it. I don't know where it is. I don't know where it's under, but you're going to need to have the pen tool. Right, here it is. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to select basically all around the edges. Now this is not going to look very perfect, but it is going to do the job. And after that, you can add more effects such as blur, radiance, discrete, and all that stuff. So you can actually make it, because after this, it's not going to look really realistic like you actually shot it with a real camera. But just make sure until you do this. Just go around here perfectly. I'm not really even taking my time right here. Normally I would take my time, but I'm just technically just making circles. As you see, it's already pretty much blurred on the sides, close to the image. So the foreground color, the background is already blurred against the foreground is actually on the focus camera point. I had my aperture. Let me read off my camera. I had the aperture on 3.4. I'm using a f1.4 zoom lens, aperture lens. So now what you want to do is you want to connect that, you want to right click, and you want to click a make selection. You want to make this about 4 pixels, and make sure this is checked, and make sure to click new selection, and just click OK. It's going to look like this. As you see, it's not perfectly aligned, but you want to really get in those cracks and crevices and see if you can actually underline them and make them perfect. Next up, you want to click on select and inverse. That way, it's going to select and blur on the background, only not the flower. Once you're here, you want to click on filter, blur, and Gaussian blur. It should be towards the bottom. Now you can actually zoom out here and zoom into more of the picture. And you can select what you want the blur to be at. As you see, you can blur it like that. It's not really going to look more like maybe 9.3 pixels. Looks more realistic to you, as you see right there. If we can just, now we can just head over to select, deselect. As you see, it doesn't look really perfect, but it looks good enough. So this is how my real aperture lens, and if I had really good lighting, would look like normally. Just that I didn't really take my time, I just took a simple shot. Anyways guys, this has been Alex teaching guys how to create a blurred background on Photoshop CS6 using just the pen tool and the select tool. Bye guys, see you in the next one.